Excuse me. I'm back at it again. Excuse me. Today I'm gonna start on fixing the intake gaskets on the Mustang. I'm gonna put a picture in right about here. And why does anybody run coolant through an intake? It is beyond me. It's just, my opinion, it's just more places for it to leak, more seals to go bad. So I guess this first part is just going to be the upper intake removal. So that way, I hate to do it like this, but I didn't have the gaskets until last night. And then I had some stuff to do. So, and then also when I woke up, I had stuff to do immediately. And it is now 3 o'clock, I'm finally free. I'm gonna try to do this quick enough to put a video up before 6 o'clock, like I promised. I apologize if it's shit. I'm sorry, I apologize if it sucks. I guess you can't say bad words on YouTube. So yeah, I'm gonna try to find a decent spot to set this down. If the angle sucks, if there's not a whole lot to see, I apologize. As I said, this video is probably gonna suck. So let's dive in. That was a time-lapse version, yeah, time-lapse, of taking off the upper intake manifold. It's really not that hard. There was some stuff I wasn't quite expecting. I didn't realize that it had an EGR tube on it. That hung me up. Excuse me. The passenger side PCV, I didn't know where that went. I tried to move the intake there at the end of it. I tried to move the intake so I could see what was holding up. And as I moved it, it just kind of plopped off. Was not expecting that at all. The four bolts in the middle were all 10s. The brackets were also all 10s. The bolt at the very front of the intake and the bolt at the very back of the intake were 15s, 15 millimeter. The nut on top of the bolt in the back was, I believe, a 13. The nut I had to take off of the throttle body stud was a 10 millimeter that also helped hold that bracket on. I used a wind. I used a 15/16 to take off the EGR tube. That was actually fairly easy. It was easier than I expected. I would have been a lot faster if I knew exactly what sizes I needed. Yeah, if I would have known exactly what I needed, I could have just set it all out instead of having to go back and forth and size match and stuff. Also, it's kind of hot. I started and it was cool. It was cloudy, cloud covered-ish, and there was a breeze. Then the sun came out and the breeze quit. And of course, as soon as I set the intake on the bed of my truck, the breeze comes back. So I guess I'm gonna have to find some extension cords later and bring my fan outside to have a little bit of air movement. Cause I don't do heat. It's hot.
And it's not even that hot here yet. I'm in the middle of Oklahoma. This is absolutely nowhere close to as hot as it's gonna get. Hopefully I'll have it to where I can actually use my garage in the next couple weeks, 2-3 weeks, something like that, hopefully. And then, yeah, at least I can be in the shade. I can have a fan in the shade. It's gonna be musty. It's gonna it'll be kind of warm for the first probably 30, 45 minutes I'm actually in there. But, excuse me. I'm gonna go make this video real quick and then, probably wait a little bit, let it cool off a little bit, and, come out and do a video on the lower intake, or I might break that into sections because it looks like there's quite a bit going on with the lower. I might break it into sections like fuel rail. I don't know. I'm just gonna wing it. I've never done one of these before. I don't have a book. I'm going off of what I found on Google the past 2 or 3 days. But I know I need to have this done, so I kind of just got to dive in. I mean, as long as it runs afterwards, I'm okay with it. Like I said, I put the picture in earlier of what it looked like. I haven't actually got the gasket off yet, the lower gasket, because like I said, it's freaking hot. But hey, buddy, how's it going? Fine then. Didn't want a grasshopper buddy anyway. But I'm gonna go in, sit in the shade, sit in the AC, cool off a little bit, let it. Airplane flew right overhead, and I don't think there's an airport anywhere close to here, which is kind of confusing because there's at least 2 or 3 planes every day. But I'm gonna go make this video, sit in the AC, cool off, get a game plan together for the lower intake, and I might just throw that up tomorrow or Tuesday. I don't know, but